Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Now in this class I'll explain you about respiration in plants. First of all, we should know the term respiration. Respiration is very important and essential life process of all living organisms. So all the living organisms perform different kinds of metabolisms or different kinds of life processes. So one of the life processes is respiration. It is very essential when comparing to all other life processes. Why it is very much essential life process in all organisms? Because respiration is the process in which energy is released from the food material. Generally, we think that food material releases energy in the process of digestion, but that is a misconception. That is wrong concept. Energy is not released in the process of digestion, but the digestive system or in the process of digestion, the nutrients are made available to release energy, but energy not released. In the process of digestion, complex food molecules are converted into simple molecules with the help of enzymes, and the simple molecules are made available to all the cells to release energy, but energy not released. So digestion make the nutrients available to the cells, but not releasing energy. And what happens in respiration? From that nutrients, whatever made available in the process of digestion, the energy is released. So respiration is a process to release energy from glucose or from any other food component which is simple molecule. From that simple molecules, energy is released in the process of respiration. So that respiration is very essential process, essential life process or metabolism of all living organisms. Now respiration in plants, we know that all the living organisms, generally all the animals, they perform respiration and they have different kinds of respiratory systems. We have an idea on that, but we may not know clearly regarding the plants. Plants also perform respiration because plants also living organisms. All the living organisms perform metabolic activity, so that plants also perform respiration. But how do the plants perform respiration? Do they have any special respiratory systems like human beings and other animals? The answer is no. Simply no. They don't have any special respiratory system. But respiration is continued. Respiration occurs. Though the respiratory system is absent in plants, respiration continues because it is a metabolism. It is essential task. How do the plants carry out the process of respiration? Let's see. All the parts of the plant body, independently they perform respiration. Leaves perform respiration, stem perform respiration, and roots perform respiration. All the parts independently, because here no system available specially for respiration, so that all the parts independently perform respiration. Let's see how the leaves perform respiration, how stem and how roots. Let's try to learn in detail. First of all, leaves. Leaves are very important parts of the plant body, because leaves perform a special task, a special activity that is called photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a process in which food material is manufactured or food material is prepared by utilizing different kinds of substances. In the process of photosynthesis, leaves receive carbon dioxide and they release oxygen. This is about photosynthesis. But in addition to photosynthesis, leaves perform respiration also. What happens in respiration? They take oxygen in and they release carbon dioxide out, just like human beings and other animals. Okay, how oxygen enters into the leaf? However, carbon dioxide enters into the leaf in the process of photosynthesis. In the same manner, oxygen enters the leaf in the process of respiration. On the lower side of the leaf, so many small minute holes are present. The small holes present on the lower side of the leaf are called stomata. Through the stomata, exchange of gases occur. Then how carbon dioxide or oxygen enters into the leaf? Simply by the process of diffusion. Here, the concentration of oxygen is more in atmosphere when comparing to the concentration of oxygen inside the leaf. So what happens? So here, by the process of diffusion, the oxygen from higher concentrated area to it enters into the lower concentrated area. That means oxygen moves from atmosphere into the leaf through the holes called stomata. Once oxygen enters, and again that is distributed to all the cells in the same process of diffusion, and all the cells receive oxygen, And when they utilize oxygen, they produce carbon dioxide. The concentration of carbon dioxide increases. So the carbon dioxide from higher concentrated area, that means from the leaf, they come out into the atmosphere through stomata in the same manner back. So the process of diffusion plays key role. By the process of diffusion, exchange of gases occurs in leaf through stomata. This is what respiration in leaves. And what about respiration in stems? Already we have learned that plants do not have any special system to send oxygen to all cells of the plant body, so that each pod independently, without depending on other pod, they try to receive oxygen from atmosphere to carry out the process of respiration. So here leaves performing respiration in the same manner, stems also performing respiration. How do they perform respiration? Yes, on the stem, on the surface of the stem also, so many small holes are present. The holes present on the surface of the stem are called lenticels. Here, the holes present on the lower side of the leaf are called stomata. But here on the surface of a stem, the holes are called lenticels. Through the lenticels, exchange of gases occurs by the process of diffusion in the same manner. However, it occurs in leaves. So here, but in some plants, if the plant having a very young stem, the bark may not be available. When the plant grows, when it becomes old, automatically external layer, additional layer is formed on the total surface of the stem, that is called bark. Even though the bark is present outside the stem, through the bark, so many small holes are present. Through the bark, the holes allow the process of exchange of gases. So here lenticels are the holes present on the surface of stem. The lenticels involve in the exchange of gases. Oxygen is taken in and distributed to all the cells. By the process of diffusion, again all the cells utilize oxygen, produce carbon dioxide, and again carbon dioxide comes out into the atmosphere through lenticels present on the surface of stem. So like this, respiration occurs in stem. And what about respiration in roots? Roots also perform respiration, because all the parts independently perform respiration. So here roots do perform respiration. How means? Here, this is the root system, and all these are the small roots. Again, all these small roots develop very, very small hair-like structures. They are called root hairs. So root hairs, all the root hairs, they have some small holes, they have some openings. So here, root hairs are distributed among the soil particles. Some air is already available in the ground. So root hairs also receive the oxygen from the soil particles present in the ground, because some gaps are present in the soil particles. The gaps are filled with air, so that root hairs receive oxygen from the soil particles. That means the air present between the soil particles, that oxygen is received by root hairs. And again, that oxygen is distributed to all parts in the same process called diffusion. And when the cells utilize oxygen, carbon dioxide is developed. The carbon dioxide also released out by the process of diffusion into the soil particles. So this is about respiration in plants.